Find the exact average value of f of x equals the square root of the quantity 9 minus x squared between 0 and 3. Then find the exact value of c in the closed interval from 0 to 3, where f of c equals the average value. The average value of a function f of x over the interval from a to b equals 1 divided by the quantity b minus a times the definite integral from a to b of f of x dx. Which means in our case, the exact average value of the given function between 0 and 3, which we'll call f sub AVE, equals 1 divided by the quantity 3 minus 0, where a is 0 and b is 3, times the definite integral from 0 to 3 of the square root of the quantity 9 minus x squared dx. Before we continue, let's focus on the given function. If we replace f of x with y, we have y equals the square root of the quantity 9 minus x squared. And if we square both sides to undo the square root, notice we have y squared equals 9 minus x squared. Adding x squared to both sides, we have x squared plus y squared equals 9, which we should recognize is a circle centered at the origin with a radius of 3. But because f of x or y is equal to the principal square root, y is positive, and x is between 0 and 3, and therefore the graph of f of x is 1/4 of a circle, shown here on the right in the first quadrant. Recognizing this will make evaluating the definite integral much simpler. Going back to the average value, we have 1/3 times the definite integral from 0 to 3 of the square root of the quantity 9 minus x squared dx equals the area under the function above the x-axis over the interval from 0 to 3, which we can see is equal to 1/4 the area of a circle with a radius of 3. And recall the area of a circle is equal to pi r squared. This indicates the average value over the interval from 0 to 3 equals 1/3 times 1/4 pi r squared, or in our case, 1/4 pi times the square of 3. Simplifying before multiplying, 3 divided by 3 simplifies to 1, which indicates 3 squared simplifies to 3 to the first, and the 3 in the denominator simplifies to 1. The exact average value of the given function over the interval from 0 to 3 equals 3/4 pi. For the second part of the question, we're asked to find the exact value of c in the closed interval from 0 to 3, where f of c equals the average value. To begin, notice f of c equals the square root of the quantity 9 minus c squared, which means to determine where f of c equals the average value, we substitute 3/4 pi for f of c and solve for c. This gives us 3/4 pi equals the square root of the quantity 9 minus c squared. And now we'll square both sides to undo the square root. Simplifying, we have 9/16 pi squared equals 9 minus c squared. Let's go ahead and solve for c squared by adding c squared to both sides and also subtracting 9/16 pi squared to both sides, which gives us c squared equals 9 minus 9/16 pi squared. And now to solve for c, we take the square root of both sides of the equation. Algebraically, we'll have a positive and negative solution. To make sure we get both solutions, we include a plus or minus on the right, which gives us c equals plus or minus the square root of the quantity 9 minus 9/16 pi squared. But again, we're looking for the value of c in the closed interval from 0 to 3, meaning the positive value of c. So for this question, the exact value of c is c equals the principal or positive square root of 9 minus 9/16 pi squared. And if you're curious, this is approximately 1.8570. But again, the question does ask for the exact value of c. Before we go, let's look at this graphically. On the left, we have the graph of the given function, and the area under the function over the interval from 0 to 3 above the x-axis is shaded in green. For the graph on the right, we found the average value of 3/4 pi, which is this y value here. If we sketch a rectangle with this height over the closed interval from 0 to 3, we have this yellow rectangle, which has the exact area as the green area on the left. And then for the second part of the question, we found this value of c, where f of c equals the average value, which again we can see here graphically. Notice this point right here is c, comma, the average function value. I hope you found this helpful.